Okay, everybody! So last week, the Rare Replay was released on the Xbox One, and I'm here to tell you whether or not this collection is worth your money. Here are my thoughts.
If you grew up as a child of the 90s, then chances are you've probably played a game by Rare at some point. One of the landmark developers of its time, Rare paved the way for gaming throughout the Super Nintendo and Nintendo 64 era, with titles like Killer Instinct, Donkey Kong Country, and GoldenEye. In the mid-2000s, the company was bought out by Microsoft, and the company continued to release games to varying degrees of success. Once the Kinect became a seminal selling point of the Xbox 360, the company then shifted focus to creating games for the Kinect, which sold well, but were ultimately underwhelming when compared to their classic counterparts. After creators Tim and Chris Stamper stepped down, and a good chunk of the original team left to go work on other games, many began to wonder if Rare would ever return to its glory days, or if it was destined to continue to release nothing but Kinect sports games until it ultimately closed down. Things began to change, however, when at this year's E3, Microsoft announced two new projects from Rare, neither of which had anything to do with Kinect sports. The first was Sea of Thieves, a multiplayer pirate adventure, and the second was the game I'm talking about today, Rare Replay. Featuring 30 games from the developer, spanning their time as Ultimate Play of the Game all the way up until the highly divisive Banjo Kazooie Nuts and Bolts, the collection is a reminder of what once was, while celebrating the potential of things to come. Now, I could probably spend a good hour or two talking about each of the games individually, but instead, I'd rather talk about the collection as a whole. Featuring everything from racing to fighting to platformers to garden simulators, Rare Replay features a wide berth of the developer's catalog, minus some of the more well-known Nintendo titles due to licensing reasons. Still, you're bound to find something to enjoy, and if nothing else, gain appreciation for how the company has grown and changed over the years. Whether you're a die-hard fan of the company or have never played one of their titles before, there's something for everyone here. What's great about this collection is the attention to detail that Rare put into recreating most of their games. From the opening musical number, to the gorgeous presentation of the main menu, to the borders that surround most of their on-disc games, you can see that a lot of effort was put into making this collection. The collectible stickers that you can use to unlock bonus interviews, concept art, and other goodies is definitely a great incentive to keep playing, and a lot of the interviews, though slightly lopsided to fit some of their more popular titles, are really quite fascinating to watch, and whether or not you're a fan, they're most certainly worth a watch. Likewise, the presentation in the games themselves have received a number of updates. Games with unruly or hard-to-control cameras have been fixed. Older games that were notoriously difficult have been given save states and a rewind feature, and even games plagued with a myriad audio or technical glitches have been smoothed over to give the game a much better feel while playing. The only downside is that a lot of the newer games, or games that have been ported over to the Xbox 360 at some point, need to be downloaded outside of the game, and a few of them don't run as smoothly as their 360 counterpart or other games featured on the disc. Add that to the fact that the game requires at least 50 gigabytes of space to download, and you're left with an initial startup time that will probably keep you waiting a bit longer than you'd probably like. Still, as a whole package, Rare Replay is truly something special. While there are bound to be those that aren't happy that some of their more well-known licensed games aren't included, or that some of their work-for-hire games are missing as well, more likely than not, you're bound to find a handful of games to enjoy, whether you played them growing up or never had a chance to play them at all. Most of the games run incredibly smooth, and the attention to detail, both in-game and in the plethora of bonus features, are very much appreciated. And anybody who loves to watch how video games have evolved over the years are bound to get a kick out of it. So if you're itching to relive bits and pieces of your childhood in one epic collection, or experience a part of gaming history for the very first time, be sure to give this one a go.
So what are your thoughts on the game? Have you had a chance to play it yet? What's your favorite Rare game? Be sure to leave a comment below letting me know what you think, but as always, be sure to like, favorite, subscribe, and share this video with whoever you want. And until then, I'll see you next time!